Okay, we're on. So we're going to just do a little recap of what went on this week in the markets. We were following oil, gold, and the dollar trade, the dollar index. Let's take a look at the dollar index first. You know, basically we... Go ahead.
Did you add me to the protein version
or... Yes, I did. I'll add you in. So, looking at the dollar index, we have broken through this consolidated zone. We've tested up and down, and we're coming into this pennant shape. So our point of control is around 81.87. We're approaching that area again, which is just on our 200 moving average, and it's probably where the 200 and the 50 are going to come together. So if price moves up, if the dollar moves up to the 81.91 area, and we show no commitment on the buyer side, we'll be looking for this to turn and then move down to the major support around 80.93. If not, we'll be watching for it to move through this resistant trend line and move back up to 82.65. Test this area. Now, if we don't get price failure in this area and move back down into this consolidated zone, then we're looking for it to continue and come up and close through this gap at 83.69.50. So those are some of the targets we're looking at. And, you know, giving this, you know, three days on the initial move, you know, in the week we'll probably break through either one of these trend lines, and then a move through in the next weeks up to test the highs, or back down to consolidate and test the support. So that's for the dollar index. On oil, last week we were watching for oil to come down and test into the consolidation zone. Well, it did move in there today. We've got
Hi, Joel. We have got a question from Turkson. He asked actually, like, what is the difference between a bond and stock? Thank you. Welcome.